What's up, everybody? Boy, did you guys catch me on a good day? Check this out, man. My fancy clothes. Ain't so fancy. I got me about an hour of time to kill before I go out and rock and roll. What am I talking about? I got a DJ tonight. Oh, yeah. I want to share with you guys a flyer for tonight's show, by the way. Nothing speaks vintage more than this flyer. It's a new club that they're doing, and I was invited to do the first show. The first of many shows, from what I heard. So that explains why I'm dressed like this. As you all know, I live a very vintage lifestyle. I don't just collect vintage baseball cards. I listen to vintage music and clothes and cars and, yeah, whatever you can think of. However, we are not here to talk about that, by the way. We are here to talk about some low-grade baseball cards. So let's start talking. Alright guys, so this is a video response for Rick Arbaugh Cards. He wants us to show off some low-grade baseball cards. And you guys all know that I love low-grade baseball cards. I have a lot of A's for awesome, 1s and 2s. And that's pretty much the majority of my collection. You know, I like nice eye appeal. I don't really care. I want the card, not the grade. And that's pretty much how I collect. I also collect very poor-looking cards. And I kind of do that for a reason. I like doing it for display cases. I like doing them for arts and crafts, you know, just to name a few. If I can pick up a Mickey Mantle low grade pour, you know, for like $10, I'm gonna pick up a low grade Mickey Mantle pour for $10, because not only is it original, it's a Mickey Mantle card. So, make sense? Yes? No? Maybe so? So, that being said, before I showcase the cards that I'm going to nominate for the contest, I do want to talk about this right here. Now, I got this in the mail the other day. I bought me a pretty cool Babe Ruth card, by the way. I was watching It Come Up an Egg, one of his videos. He was doing a Roy Campanella showcase. And he showed this card, and I was like, you know what? That's a very funny card. I'm going to buy it. So I bought it. And then it came in this little bad boy. I'll show you the card, guys. It's this right here. That's a really cool card. How could you not want this right here? This is really cool. But unfortunately, it came in this little bad boy right here. And you know what? What should be an X Mint card, because, you know, it's brand new. It's newly made. It is now a poor condition card because they sent this card just like this. Yeah. They didn't cover it. Nope. They didn't protect it. Nope. Boom, boom. Here you go. Here's your card. I guess I can't complain because I only paid $1 for this and $1 for shipping. So technically I paid $2. But there's this big old ding right here. You're not going to be able to see, but there's a big old ding right here. And yeah, that was pretty annoying, guys. I don't understand. So this card is now a low-grade card. And it kind of classifies this video response now, right, guys? No? Yes? Whatever. I bought another Babe Ruth card. Okay, not the same one. Nope, not the same one. If you guys saw my videos, my Hall of Fame binder videos that I did, I mentioned that I bought a Babe Ruth card. And I was going to use that card to put it in a picture frame, you know, so I can put it on my wall. Well, they shipped it in this little bad boy. No protection. Look how thin that is, dude. Wow. Here's the card. Here's another low-grade card, by the way. This is what they sent me. Or at least when I got it. Look at that. Wow. I bought an authentic. I paid $20 for this at the time. Look how sharp that is. Love it. That's the reason why I bought it. $20, affordable. I can use this as a picture frame. Put it on my wall. That's the whole purpose of buying this. And then I get this, and now it's a low-grade card. See, now this bothers me, only because this is vintage. This is not. This is thin, and I don't know if you guys can see, but in the back, this is definitely a low-grade card now with paper loss because, you know, there's two pieces, and it kind of pushed it in here, and yeah, you know, what a shame, you know, what a shame. if cards are already low grade, I don't mind buying them like that. But when you're creating a low grade card like this without protecting it properly, you know, that kind of bothers me. It's like those old cards where they chop it up, you know. I like them original, like why tamper with them? But whatever, to each their own, whatever. But this literally happened a week apart. Can you guys believe that? That's crazy, dude. Crazy. So I've been striking out with my Babe Ruth cards. But whatever, you know, what do you do? Anyways, I do want to share with you guys some low-grade cards. As you guys know, I do love low-grade cards. I'm going to share three of them before I share my finale, the one that I want into the contest. Okay, so let me see how this kind of works because I'm usually turning the camera around. Here is my Phil Rizzuto. And by the way, I want to give a shout out to George Diamond Yard Sports. He gave me these low-grade baseball cards. He asked me if I wanted them, and I was like, sure, I can definitely use these low-grade baseball cards. Here's some 1952s with some jizz in the back. Who doesn't like the jizz? Luke Easter, Phil Rizzuto, and the Johnny Mize. Check this out. Some beaters. Damn, I love them. And I'm going to make a video regarding low-grade cards. I'm going to do a little showcase of all the low-grade cards that I have and why I collect them and why I want them. This is just a video response for Rick Oddball Cards. You know, I'm going to throw in my nomination for his contest, which is going to be this card. And I won this card for $2. After shipping, I paid $5. And to me, this is a one-of-one. A special one-of-one because there was nothing like it and I wanted it. And luckily nobody bid on it. I bought this card like 10 years ago, guys. 10 years ago. I can't believe this. A 1954 Bowman. And this is my nomination right here. My one card for your contest, Rick. My one card. There you go. Look at that. A 101. This right here is a 1954 Bowman that someone decided to cut out. Okay. Now, what makes this card very interesting is this is a preacher roll card, okay? He was pretty famous in the 1950s for the Dodgers. He's a Dodger pitcher. It's autographed right there. I won this for $2 like 10 years ago. Okay, I don't know how long it was. I think it was 10 years ago. I've had this card for a very long time. I'll tell you that. But here's the back. A 1954 Bowman. Yeah, that's crazy, guys. That's crazy. I'm not sure if you're going to be seeing these type of cards anymore because I don't think people are dumb enough to be cutting these cards up like that. You know, they did it back then because they weren't really collectibles or what they're considered today. Back then, who knows when that was cut? I'm assuming it was back then. I'm hoping, you know, I don't think anyone's, you know, kind of dumb enough to be doing that nowadays, but you never know. There's people out there that tamper with things. People out there that don't know how to ship things, and people that just don't like protecting things. So that's my video response. This is my one card. Hopefully it's a good entry. And yeah, you're not gonna beat a 101 autograph preacher row 1954 Bowman. So I'll see you guys on the next one. I gotta run. I gotta go rock and roll, go DJ, and have some fun. Toodles.